What's up, guys? Brendan here from Trickle Wild TV. Today is Fantastic Friday! We are right now currently in El Paso, Texas. We could spit and we could see the border. Right now, we're currently at our pickup location and we're about to crack open the trailer. People here are very, very nice. I had an open window from 0700 to 1600 to load. But I could have made it yesterday, but I decided to trot in because the weather where I'm going, be no rush for me to get there because there's a storm front coming through. It's going out to, I believe, Wisconsin. I'll get right back.
In your face, that'll put you in your place. Seven letters on the plate, fuck you when I break. I got cars, I got bags, I got real estate. Full play, I ain't gonna play. I got big fish money, he gon' bite the bait.
Hey guys, so I'm back. So I'm in the dock door. Very nice people here. Just jumped out and checked my oil, checked my belts. Did my windows as usual. And kind of stinks. I want to get the spruce goose washed, but I know I'm going to be riding through some storms, so it's kind of not worth spending the $100 right now. So, looks like we're, of course, the broker tells me yesterday it's only going 1,480 miles. And then when you put it in the, you know, the good old Garmin, it's 1,683 with limited tolls, and then it's 18 something without no tolls. That changes the game. So, these brokers make me feel a certain kind of way. But we got to, we could have made it in yesterday to load, but we took a slow ride. And we got here, we got a spot over at the Petro. Went inside, got a good dinner at the Iron Skillet. And then was involved in a couple good phone calls. And then I was doing some work on me last night. A lot of realizations about some stuff. And, my heart is just heavy, you know, when you miss people and, you know, you can't talk to people and stuff like that. It's kind of rough, you know what I mean? So I guess that's just what keeps me on my grind for the hope that tomorrow, maybe something better could happen. So I'm just doing my thing. We're all set, and I'll be right back. So really nice guy. That was the quickest load ever. Like 10 minutes, not even. I'm hauling, it's like 5,000 or 6,000 pounds worth of fans. Nice and light. I'm stacked from ceiling to toe all the way to the back. And everything's all strapped and secured. And then we're going to make our way out of Texas. So, this weather, crazy, man. Many prayers going out to those people that were caught in that pile up out there. And I know Beetle Bailey had texted me. I don't know if he was involved or rolled up on it, but he was out making a delivery. And just that video of watching that FedEx truck go over the top of those cars made me sick to my stomach. That's why, like, you know, I'll do what I can. I'll do my due diligence. But if I ever see that the weather, you know, like the other night when I was in Kansas, I got off the road, it was sleeting so bad and the truck was just sliding from side to side. I knew it was time. You know, there's nothing you're going to do with ice. You know, so I got off the road, did what I had to do, and it was okay. It was Gucci. So, and that's the night when the truck left me stranded when it was -7 when she Spruce Goose was mad at me. So we're all good now. Everything seems to be well, and a lot of good things, man. You know, this whole thing that I'm going through right now, I can actually see light at the end of the tunnel, which is awesome. I could actually see some kind of future, but I don't know what the future has in store for me. A lot of people have sent me messages and turned around people that were in my circle, which shows me I'm doing the next right thing. But there's still silence among people that my heart is really heavy about. And there's nothing I could do, you know. And I don't know how bad the damage is or what it is. But I could tell you I am thankful for the situation that I'm in. Because me hitting that, like, rock bottom, you know, that ultimate destruction with nothing left, gave me what I need so I could be humble and listen and pay attention and start connecting the dots. And this guy Rich I work with, I spent a couple hours on the phone with him the night before last, and then I was on the phone with him last night, another 90 minutes, and we were just talking about stuff. And he tells me that my closest friends will recognize that something's wrong with me before I actually can identify it myself. So if I'm quiet or, you know, acting out of sorts, he says usually your close circle will know something's up with you, and the indicator is when they tell you something, pay attention. Pay attention to what they say. So it's, I gotta tell you, man, it's a new way of living. It's a new thought of mine, different thought process. Nothing's the end of the world. Everything can be worked out, doing the next right thing. Yeah, I'm kind of down for that. I'm kind of down for that ride. You know what I mean? Just years and years, man. Years and years of damage and, you know, doing business, you know, and the type of business I was in. You know, it had the glamour side of it, but there was a lot of stuff that was unso glamorous. And it really took a toll on me. It really, really took a toll on me. I can't, to this day, I'm finally starting to check out heavy records as I look, as you know, going by an accident scene or something. For the longest time, I couldn't even look at a record or tow truck. I was so burnt out, so cooked on it. But the one thing that always stayed in my heart was big trucks. You know, always look at big trucks and everything like that. But it's just you get this damage and then you get forced. You know, when you have a job and you love it, it's not a job. It's just a way of life. You know, like trucking is a way of life. You know, and this job, Beast came out with a good video last night about depression that the guys go through and the things that happen. And we got a close friend that some stuff is going down. And we all got his back. We all got his back. He's a great dude. And he puts up one persona on YouTube, but the guys that know him and hang out with him and talk to him on the regular, he's completely something different, you know? And we're all there for that guy. That guy's in a lot of pain, and he's hurting. You know, he's going through some pretty terrible stuff right now. But, you know, thing is, I'm going through my thing, my situation too, and I can use what I've learned to help him, you know? And just before he let it go yesterday, I was able to talk him off the ledge the day before that and repay him, because as many times he talked me off the ledge with a lot of things. So, you know, he's a good, solid dude, but he's honest. He's honest. You know, he's got that honest bone like me that wants to get to the crux of things and let's get things rocking and rolling and keep on trucking, you know? And I appreciate that struggle, because that struggle is so real. It is so real. So this is Truck A Wild for today, reminding you that it is Fantastic Friday. If you're out on the road, know there's a family that needs you at home. You are loved, you are missed, and you are special. You are an awesome person, and no matter how stinking thinking you're doing or how you're feeling a certain kind of way, know that you're loved and missed, and try to put a smile on someone else's face today. That smile might mean the meaning of someone walking the plank or walking away from the plank, and we never know what someone else is going through. We're not in their shoes. You know, we can only surmise that someone's going through a hard time, but the truth is, we never know what people are feeling. We never know what's going on with them. So measure twice, cut once, make a smile when you can, you know. Change a thought, move a muscle, do all those great things that are good for you and for the people in your circle and your family. And remember, always hold your family dear, true, close to your heart, and do the next right thing. And I guarantee you, the Lord up above isn't going to leave you on your butt. You know, he might smack you around a little bit, and he's got a very, very, our God's got a very, very good sense of humor, I can tell you that. So I hold on to that, and I got great faith, and I have faith in all you. So you guys inspire me to stay on this trail and this mission and keep doing the next right thing and rebuilding my life. And thank you for taking the journey with me. I'm Truck A Wild from El Paso, Texas. Live, but not live, but still alive. Remember, always keep God first. Love your wife or ex-wife like it was our first or last date, even when you made a mess, and everything else will come into play. Truck A Wild reporting. Stay up, stay blessed. Love you all. Talk to you tomorrow.